shuttle valve. It has two inlet ports, inlet port A and inlet port B, and one outlet port, that is C is the outlet port. The C port is connected to single acting cylinder. When there is supply of fluid to port A, then the valve will shift towards right. It will close the port B and it allows flow to cylinder port. When fluid is given to port B, then the valve will be pressed towards the port A. Port A is closed. From port B, fluid flows to cylinder port. If fluid supply is given to port A as well as port B together, then valve will stay in the middle and fluid flow to port C is there. That is, if input A is present, input B is present, if both inputs are present, then there will be output at C. If any one of the input is present, that is, if input A is present, B is not there, then also there will be output. If input B is present, A is absent, then also there will be output. If there is no input A, if there is no input B also, then there won't be output at C. This is OR logic function. The construction is simple. It has a ball or puppet inside the valve body as shown here, and this ball or puppet will move because of the pressure of the working fluid. If the working fluid is given to A, then the ball will shift towards B and it will close the port B. It will allow fluid flow to port C. In the same way, if working fluid is supplied to B, then it will close the port A. It will allow fluid to flow to port C. And this is a circuit having shuttle valve here. It has two palm button operated, spring return type, normally closed type, 3x2 valves. This is one 3x2 valve, this is one 3x2 valve. In normal position, there is connection from A to T, and here also from B to T. A and B are the cylinder ports, and hence the cylinder retracts. If valve A is pressed, then connection is made from pump port to A port of this valve, and hence fluid will flow from P, A and then through the shuttle valve to the cylinder. Cylinder will extend. If valve B is pressed, from pump oil flows to B and then to the shuttle valve and then to the cylinder. Cylinder will extend. If both valves A and B are pressed together, then also fluid will flow to the cylinder. Cylinder will extend. If none of these two valves are pressed, then cylinder will retract. Twin pressure valve. Again, this valve is also having two inlet ports, port A and port B, and one outlet port, that is port C. It has AND logic function, means when fluid is supplied to both the ports, port A and port B together, then only there will be flow at outlet port C. This is truth table. Input A is present, input B is also present, then only there will be output at port C. If A is present, B is not there, or if B is present, A is not there, or there is no input A, there is no input B, in all these cases, there won't be output at C. Construction. Twin pressure valve consists of a spool inside the valve body. When the working fluid is supplied to any one inlet port, the spool closes the outlet. If the working fluid is supplied to both inlet ports together, then only the outlet port is open, so that fluid flow will be there at outlet port. AND logic is used in a safety circuit called two-hand operation of press, in which both hands of the operator are engaged in pressing the two valves. Thereby, it avoids his hands being left between the punch and die. Again, this is circuit diagram using twin pressure valve. This is valve A and this is valve B. These two valves are push button operated, spring return type, normally closed, 3x2 direction control valves. If the valves are not pressed, then there is connection from cylinder port to tank port, and hence cylinder will retract. If valve A is pressed, then from pump, oil flows to A port of the twin pressure valve. The inside spool will shift towards right. It will close the port C so that oil cannot flow to cylinder. Cylinder will not extend. If valve B is pressed, again, oil flows to the right side port of the twin pressure valve, that is port B. The spool will shift towards left. It will close the passage so that the cylinder will not extend because there is no supply to that cylinder. When valve A as well as valve B both are pressed together, then fluid flows close to valve from both sides, and the spool will stay somewhere in between, and fluid flows to port C and cylinder will extend.